with my Savior am happy and blessed, watching and waiting, looking above, filled with his goodness, lost in his love. This is my story, this is my song.
And are we yet alive and see each other's face? Glory and praise to Jesus given for his redeeming grace. My brothers and sisters, I greet you warmly in the name of Jesus Christ. Welcome also to those joining us via social media. I pray that this service may be a blessing for us all. We begin our worship with the hymn numbered 242 in the VIP, 242, I'll praise my Maker while I have breath. Please be seated. I invite you to make the appropriate response to the call to worship. Let us come before the Lord with open hearts. Let us bring our broken dreams, our conflicts, and our griefs. For God is good, and out of sorrow will come new gladness. The Lord will fill us again with power to sing with joyful hearts. Gracious God, we praise you and thank you for all that you have bestowed upon us, for this day in which we have our being, for your word which refreshes us as we open ourselves to it, for your wisdom which comes to us as we follow Jesus, for the light that shines upon us when we turn to you in prayer. Help us this day to glorify your name in our hymns and songs, and in our prayers and meditation in this sanctuary, and by all that we say and do before others when we leave it. Help us to be the salt of the earth and the light to the world. We ask it through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us go to God in prayer. Magnificent Father, today we admire and honor you. You are our God, and we submit our loyalty and adoration to you. You are the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. You existed before time and created everything that exists. Lord, only you have held the ocean in your hand. You measured off the heavens with your fingers, and you know how much the earth weighs. You are truly amazing. Father, all nations of the world are but a drop in the bucket to you. They are nothing more than dust on the scales. You pick up the whole earth as though it were a grain of sand. Lord, you sit above the circle of the earth. The people below are like grasshoppers to you. You spread out the heavens like a curtain and make your tents from them. When you look up at the sky, we know that you created every star that we see. You bring them out like an army, one after the other, calling each by its name. Because of your great power and incomparable strength, not a single one is missing. Lord, you are the everlasting God, the creator of all the earth. You never grow weary or weak. No one can measure the depths of your understanding. You are good to everyone and show compassion on all your creation. Mighty King, you are our banner and shield, our strength and protection. Lord Jesus, you are Savior, Redeemer, and through you we are justified. Holy Spirit, you are our advocate, our helper, and the source of power. We reverence and honor you, the triune God. Amen. The commandments of our Lord Jesus. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, the first commandment is, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. And you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength. Lord, have mercy upon us and incline our hearts to keep this law. The second is this, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. Lord, have mercy upon us and incline our hearts to keep this law. And the new commandment I give to you, that you love one another, even as I have loved you, that you also love one another. Lord, have mercy upon us, and write all these your laws in our hearts, we beseech you. Together we pray, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against each other, in thought and word and deed, in the evil we have done and in the good we have not done, through ignorance, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past and grant that we may serve you in newness of life to the glory of your name. Amen. Let us, in the silence of our hearts, bring our own confessions to God. Merciful and gracious God, our hearts cry out for you to make us whole again. Even as we celebrate that you have come to dwell within us, we have sinned against you and abandoned your commandments. We have been jealous, possessive, ambivalent, and impulsive. We have not heeded your word, and we have not cherished your covenant. Help us to glorify you in all times and in all places. As our souls thirst for your living waters, quench our needs and satisfy our love, that we may come back to you and be sent forth to fill the world with your mercy and grace. Your Spirit is here. Your church is born, and the day of the Lord is coming. You have gathered all people together in your Spirit, and you have brought life to all valleys of death. Still, O Lord, we cannot trust, for we fear our bones are beyond repair. Still, O Lord, we cannot turn away, for we fear our hope is lost. Still, O Lord, we imagine isolation, for we fear we are cut off from your presence. Forgive us, Holy One. As you did for your first church, breathe the fire of life into us. As you did for your prophet Ezekiel, reveal to us your life-giving presence. In the name of Jesus Christ, your Son, and the power of the Holy Spirit who is at work within us. Amen. My brothers and sisters, God assures us of his pardon and brings us new life when our bones are dry, and hope when we are hopeless. God washes us in mercy and ignites us with the Spirit. By the grace of God through Jesus Christ, we are forgiven and set free. Let us thank God as we pray. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we humbly thank you for your goodness to us and all that you have made. We praise you for your creation, for keeping us and all things in your care, and for all the blessings of life. Above all, we bless you for your immeasurable love in redeeming the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies, and with thankful hearts we praise you, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving ourselves to your service and by living in your gifts of holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be all worship and praise, now and forever. Amen. Amen. We continue with the hymn numbered 407, The Church is One Foundation, is Jesus Christ, our Lord, 407 in the VIP.
Oh,
And as we go into the ministry of the word, let us pray together the collect appointed for today. Almighty God, you have given us your servants by grace and by the confession of a true faith to acknowledge the glory of the eternal Trinity and in the power of the divine majesty to worship the unity. Keep us steadfast in his faith that we may evermore be defended from all adversities through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The gospel appointed for today comes to us from Matthew chapter 28, verse 16 to 20. Matthew 28, 16 to 20. I invite you to stand. Now, the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had directed them. When they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. And Jesus came and said to them, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe everything that I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always to the end of age." This is the gospel of Christ. Our hymn of preparation is numbered 180 in the VIP, 180. Rescue the perishing, care for the dying, 180.
Rescue the perishing, care for the dying, snatch them in pity from sin and the grave. Weep o'er the erring one, lift up the fallen, tell them of Jesus the mighty to save. Rescue the perishing, care for the dying. Jesus is merciful, Jesus will save. Though they are slighting him, still he is waiting, waiting the penitent child to receive. Plead with them earnestly, plead with them gently. He will forgive if they only believe. Rescue the perishing, care for the dying. Jesus is merciful, Jesus will save. Down in the human heart, crushed by the tempter, feelings lie buried that grace can restore. Touched by a loving heart, wakened by kindness, cords ever broken will vibrate once more. Rescue the perishing, care for the dying, Jesus. watching, care for the dying. Jesus is merciful. Jesus will save.
Please be seated. I now invite our superintendent, Reverend Ampadu, who will bring us the word.
Good morning, my brothers and sisters in Christ. We are happy this morning to see many of you coming out for worship. We thank God for the opportunity given to us again, even in the midst of all the trials and the challenges. God has given us the grace to be able to meet in persons again. So we want to give thanks to God. And also we pray that our brothers and sisters who could not make it today, next week, God willing, all of us will be able to come together again. We know and we are sure that our protection comes from God. Even though we are taking precautions, but we know that this God will continue to keep all of us. So we want to thank God for this wonderful day. And we pray that God's strength will continue to be with us, that you continue to strengthen us each day. Today is Communion Sunday. Today is Trinity Sunday. So today, because of the social distances and what have you, during the communion, you will sit at your station, wherever you are sitting. You will sit there and we will come and serve you from where you are sitting. So please feel free, sit comfortably. We will bring the communion to you. And during the offering, it will be a walk-up offering. We will put the bowl here. You come, you drop, you go and sit down. We don't want social contact. So let us observe these rules and regulations so that even as God is protecting us, we are also protecting ourselves. Let me also thank our technicians for a good job they have done. You know, from next week going, we may not have a live broadcast, but we will record and put it on our page so that those who will not be able to come out will also watch from there. Thank you very much. Let us bow our heads as we go to God in prayer. Oh God of grace, God of mercy, God of love, we thank you for the past 2 months. We have not been able to come together as family, one family, oh God. But today by your grace and your divine providence, you have opened us, O God, to come back and fellowship with each other and with you, O God. So we want to thank you. We pray for our brothers and sisters who could not make it this morning into your hands. Wherever they are, Lord, the blessings that you are going to pour upon us, we pray that, Lord, they will also receive their portion wherever they are. We pray for all our listeners and our viewers on Facebook, wherever they are listening from, Lord. We ask, O God, that your blessings will be upon them, O God. We pray at this time, even as your word is coming, open our hearts, our minds, O God, and talk to us. We pray that, Lord, your presence will fill us, O God. The power in your word will liberate us from every trouble, challenge that your people are facing. So gracious Lord, we are in your hands. Have your own way. Let your purpose and your will be established in our lives. We thank you through your Son Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen and amen. My brothers and sisters, today we observe as Trinity Sunday. Trinity is the Christian understanding of Godhead as one in three persons, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. It suggests to us that the relationship that exists in the Godhead. So in our gospel reading, we observe this important day that the text brings to us, which is the Great Commission inspired by the Trinity, God, Son, Holy Spirit. So this morning, our theme is relationship building is central to the Great Commission. Relationship building is central to the Great Commission. And I'm reading from Matthew chapter 28, verse 18 and 20. Matthew 28, 18 to 20, and it reads, "And Jesus came and said to them, 'All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to observe everything that I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always to the end of the age.'" I am with you always to the end of the age. My brothers and sisters, and for me, this text is very important. As we celebrate Trinity Sunday, today being the Great Commission Sunday, we live in a world groaning in pain at harsh attacks on human dignity stemming from crime, violence, racial abuse of color differences, a world where wickedness is dominating, cruelty, institutionalized exclusion, and systemic discrimination. We are in a time where the rich and the powerful have chosen exclusion as their tactics to retain their dominant status. We are in a time where the weak, the children, the vulnerable, and the marginalized, they pay a high price by the injustice they face in our world. It seems to me that the peace in our world is threatened, looking at the tension in the Minneapolis in state as a result of the death of George Floyd amidst of this COVID-19 crisis. Today, if we look around our world, all we see, lives that are broken with no hope, lives with no meaning for a better future for the masses of our young people and the children. If we look around our world, we see suffering, we see pain, we see lost dreams, we see homelessness, people who are hungry and begging for a dollar to survive. My brothers and sisters, when we watch our television screens, it is filled with worrying pictures. We see shootings, we see killing, starvation, deaths as a result of COVID-19, and the list could go on and on. Today, fear of violence and racial abuse is paralyzing and polarizing our world. The celebration of violence in our social media, music that we play, and even the video games that we are watching, sometimes it poisons our society. Beyond the violence on our streets is the violence in our hearts, hostility, hatred, despair, and indifference are the growing culture of violence in our society. My brothers and sisters, today we have verbal violence in our families, in our communications, talk shows. All these things contribute to this culture of violence in our society. And I ask the question, looking at all these happenings around us, how can we begin to change our world in this crisis time? How can we seek to be the voice to speak with courage, conviction against injustice in the world around us. My brothers and sisters, how can we move past our own discomfort in speaking out to provide comfort for others who have so much more to lose? Are we making our voice heard enough on issues that are affecting humanity? Do we speak out boldly against economic injustices that leave our youth, women and workers, minorities and groups feeling vulnerable? How often is our heart broken for the brokenness of the world around us? It is in this context we approach our test. So in our test, Jesus says, go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and also teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always to the end of the age. So the context of this test follows the event of Easter morning, the resurrection of Jesus from the dead, the report of the angel, the women and the girls. We assume the women got through to Jesus' disciples since they have gone to Galilee in line with the message the women were given. And this action takes place in Galilee. My brothers and sisters, the 11 disciples, having spoken to Mary, they headed to Galilee, to a mountain where they were to meet Jesus. We are told, after meeting with Jesus, he gave them instruction. And that instruction is what we refer to today as the Great Commission. So in the text, Jesus sends the disciples out with a reminder of the promise made to Abraham that all nations will be blessed by Abraham's offspring. Go make disciples of all nations. My brothers and sisters, then Jesus add his command, baptize them and teach them to obey all the things I have taught you. And finally, Jesus add a promise, I will be with you all. So the Great Commission challenges us to go beyond national and tribal prejudices, to build relationship as existed in the Godhead, the Trinity, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. So the Great Commission, my brothers and sisters, it is about building relationship. The Great Commission is our Lord's command to take the gospel to every person throughout the world and to make disciples in all nations. In other words, to build relationships. Sometimes, my brothers and sisters, we limit the Great Commission to be proclamation of the gospel only. But I think the Great Commission goes beyond the proclamation of the Word of God. It goes beyond that. Jesus expects his disciples to do all that he had taught them and by extension, replicate their lifestyle of obedience by teaching it to others. My brothers and sisters, so the Great Commission is not only for us to go and make converts. Making converts is very good, but it is the role of the Holy Spirit. Our duty is to build relationship so that the Holy Spirit can work through us. My brothers and sisters, we are actually mandated to go and build relationships with people not like us, so that we may be the bridge that leads them to Jesus. And this requires action. So the heart of the Great Commission is the command to participate in creating Christ's followers, that bear his image in the way that we live our lives. My brothers and sisters, you could see that the Great Commission carries with it an assumption. Jesus assumed those who have had an experience with him, whereby they know that he has died on the cross for them, rose again in victory, and is alive, regenerating their heart. Those people will surely tell others. These people will befriend others so that the Holy Spirit can work through us to them. So the truth of the matter is that if people are going to become disciples of Jesus, they have to recognize that we ourselves, we are disciples of Jesus and want to become like us. So the question is, how can they become like Jesus or like us if we fail to build that relationship with them? How can they come? It's time to reason that God's mission is about life for all. The Great Commission is about building relationships. Relationships are key to obeying the Great Commission. So we are commanded to go and make disciples. In other words, to build relationships. My brothers and sisters, the Great Commission, like I said, is not only about going to proclaim the word of God. It is part of it. Rather, it also involves teaching the people about social justice. Apart from the proclamation, it is also about teaching the people about social justice. So if you look at the text, verse 26, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. So my brothers and sisters, the Great Commission is also about teaching people to value social justice. And when we talk about social injustice, it refers to something that is wrong in the society, such as racial abuse that is going on in the state, child abuse, human trafficking, robbery, domestic violence, corruption among some state officials and some civil servants, favoritism, and the list could go on and on. These are some of examples of social justice, social injustice that Jesus wants to teach people to avoid in our society if we want to carry out the Great Commission. Today being Trinity Sunday, God is inviting you and I to go out there and proclaim his word and also to teach people to practice social justice. As part of our mandate to carry out the Great Commission, God wants you and I to be fair in all our dealings with other people in the society. Note that justice is when the strong protect the weak rather than taking advantage of them. Justice is when people are offered helping hand rather than use them and dump them. It is about lifting people up and not put them down. Justice is where we help each other. The Red Great Commission is when compassion and caring replace coldness and indifference. My brothers and sisters, the question is, what kind of treatment do we give to people who are different from us? How do we treat those perceived to be poor in our society? Those seen to be vulnerable and strangers, the weak in the society. How do we treat them? How does the system treat such people? How does government policies treat those who are vulnerable in our communities? How does the resources in our society are being distributed? These are critical questions that we need to answer as far as the Great Commission is concerned. Today, God is sending you and I to teach people to practice social justice. Humanity flourishes. Society flourishes. Families flourishes where there is justice and righteousness. We need to lead the crusade of social justice to bring change in our society. As part of the Great Commission, we have to demand change in every system that is oppressive to the poor and the needy. We have to make sure that we do not support and participate in policies and systems that seek to exploit the poor and the needy in the society. System that bring injustice into the lives of other people. My brothers and sisters, the Great Commission is also about social justice. It's not only a matter of holding a Bible in the presence of the whole world for people to know and to see that you are a Christian. And behind the scene, you oppress other people. That is not social justice. That is not what the Bible is teaching us. It's not the case of putting the Bible in your armpit and walk all over. We need social justice. The second thing the text brings to mind is that the Great Commission is also involves helping people to discover their humanness and their full potential. The Great Commission is also involves helping people to discover their humanness and their full potential. So in the text, Jesus said, teaching them to obey everything. So the key verse here, the key word is teaching. We need to teach people to develop their full potentials, to affirm their dignity. So the question is, what did Jesus do in his ministry before these disciples that he commanded them to go out there to do the same? In Jesus' ministry, the Bible attests to the fact that he affirmed the dignity of humanity. When you look at the example from the Bible, the woman caught in adultery, this woman deserved to be stoned to death. People were ready to stone this woman to death. But what did Jesus do? Jesus set her free, forgave her, and affirmed her dignity. That is the ministry that has been entrusted into our hands. Jesus healed the sick. He healed the brokenhearted. He fed the hungry. He welcomed the rejected. He associated himself with the outcast and the marginalized in the society. He took particular attention for the homeless, and he built relationship with those society have ignored and overlooked. My brothers and sisters, this is the ministry that has been entrusted into our hands. So the Great Commission, we are to feed the hungry around us. We are to show compassion. We are to treat people with respect and care and dignity. We share our food with those who do not have. In the Great Commission, we share our talent. We share our time with others. We share our knowledge to benefit other people. We are to liberate those that society has ignored, to help people on the fringes to discover their full potentials. This is the Great Commission that Jesus is talking about. It is not only the proclamation, but to teach people to develop their full potentials. My brothers and sisters, the path to compassionate society arises from the intention and actions of individuals within that society. There must be action rooted in generosity and kindness, restraining our selfishness,
aggression and anger. Make an effort to cultivate and grow gentleness, kindness, and generosity so that our experience becomes like Jesus Christ. This is what we have been called to do as Christians to fulfill that great commission. Today in our society, there are so many people who are broken. So many people in our society who are hurt, who have been disowned. They need people whom they can connect with. Such people are lonely. They don't have family. They don't have friends. Their neighbors don't talk to them. They are all alone in this world. And at least that is how they feel. There are some people in our society who are also being bullied and discriminated against in their own family, in their own neighborhood, at their workplaces, on the street, and everywhere. It is because the color of their skin is not right, their size or their looks are not right, or because they have a funny accent. People who are pushed down all the time to the point where death seems to be the only way out of their distress. Such people are the people that we have been sent to go to them, to meet them, to encourage them, to affirm them that Jesus loves them. My brothers and sisters, today Jesus invites us as part of our mission to pay attention to the needs of others, to spend time with such people, to just talk to them. The boys in the ghettos, they need our attention. They need our love. They need friends. In fact, they have made a mistake and they know they don't want friends who will chastise them. They know they have made a mistake. It is our duty to go to such people and affirm their dignity. My brothers and sisters, finally, the Great Commission also invites us to be the voice for the voiceless in the society. Like I said, the Great Commission is not only proclamation, but it is also giving a voice to the voiceless. So as part of our mandate, we are to liberate people who are ignored, people who cannot speak for themselves, people when they attempt to raise their voices are prevented from expressing themselves. People, system may try to prevent them from speaking. Those who are locked in prison without being trialed. The Great Commission mandates us to be advocates for the marginalized, the vulnerable, and the disadvantaged. Our role as Christians is to make our voice heard. We must continue to speak on behalf of the voiceless. But more importantly, we must also empower them, to equip them to speak for themselves. Go and teach them. My brothers and sisters, as part of our mandate, we are called to confront the powers that silence people. We must speak against policies that continue to impoverish and oppress people and deny them their human rights. We must speak against systems that prevent resources from reaching all people equitably. We must speak against selective justice. We must speak against the pollution of our waters, pollution of the air and the soil. And the list could go on and on. My brothers and sisters, as I conclude today, as part of our responsibility to fulfill the Great Commission, we are invited to value diversity and recognize that different people bring different perspectives, ideas, knowledge, and culture, and that the difference brings great strength. Let us challenge inequalities in our society. Let us speak against any system and policy that seeks to oppress and suppress and discriminate against anyone in our society. Let us respond to individuals in courteous manner, sensitive and caring way. And for me, that is the Great Commission. So as I conclude, my brothers and sisters, be reminded, the Great Commission is not only about proclamation of the gospel. It is also about building relationships. It is about social justice. It is about helping others to develop their full potentials. It is about being a voice for the voiceless. It is my prayer that as faith community, we will continue to stand for those on the fringes, to speak for them, to build relationship so that the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ can be carried out to every part of the world. In the name of God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us bow heads as we go to God in prayer. The word of God has come to you today, reminding you the Great Commission is not only proclamation of the word of God. It is also about relationship building, building relationships so that the gospel can reach to everyone. It is about teaching people about social justice, the children from scratch, to respect every human being, helping other people to develop their full potential. Are you fulfilling this mandate that has been given to you? Just be quiet before God and just reflect on these ways and ask yourself, am I availing myself for the Spirit of God to work through me to reach out to other people to build that relationship? And so, Lord, we thank you for reminding us today about the Great Commission. That the Great Commission is not only about proclamation, but also it involves building relationships so that we become like a bridge to bring others, God, unto you. We pray that, Lord, help us to be conscious. If we have broken relationship in our communities, in our neighborhoods, at our workplaces, we pray that, Lord, give us the strength that wherever we find ourselves, we'll be able to build and bridge the gap between everyone, oh God, that, Lord, people will look at our lives and draw closer to you. So, Lord, your people are in your hands. We pray that, Lord, continue to empower us, that, Lord, we will be able to carry out this mandate of social justice. And we pray at this time, where there is absence of social justice, oh God, where there is injustice, we pray that, Lord, there will be justice, oh God. We pray especially for our brothers and sisters in Minneapolis, oh God. We ask, oh God, that there will be justice for our brother George Floyd and all those who have been accused and killed without trial, without anything. Those who have been imprisoned, oh God, without justice. We ask, oh God, that give us the boldness to speak, to be the voice for those people. We want to thank you, gracious Lord. Have your own way and let your perfect will be done in our lives through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen and amen.
My brothers and sisters, We are called to be members of the royal priesthood, and at this time we will intercede on behalf of our brothers and sisters. Your response to the prayer will be listened to our prayer. Let us pray. O God, our healer, show your compassion for the whole human family that is in turmoil and burdened with illness and with fear. Hear our cry, O God. Come to our aid as the coronavirus spreads globally. Heal those who are sick. Support and protect their families and friends from being infected. Hear our cry, O God. Listen to our prayer. Grant us your spirit of love and self-discipline so that we may come together, working to control and eliminate the coronavirus. Hear our cry, O God. Listen to our prayer. Make us vigilant, attentive, and proactive in the eradication of all diseases, malaria, dengue, HIV and AIDS, cancer, and others that create suffering and often result in death for many people. Hear our cry, O God. Listen to our prayer. Heal our self-centeredness and indifference that makes us worry only when the virus threatens us. Open ways beyond timidity and fear that too easily ignore our neighbor. Hear our cry, O God. Listen to our prayer. Strengthen and encourage those in public services and in the medical profession, caregivers, nurses, attendants, doctors, all who commit themselves to caring for the sick and their families. Hear our cry, O God. Listen to us. Inspire, give insight and hope to all researchers focused on developing a vaccine. Hear our cry, O God. Sustain all workers and business owners who suffer loss of livelihood due to shutdowns, quarantines, closed borders, and other restrictions. Protect and guard all those who must travel. Hear our cry, O God. Guide the leaders of nations that they speak the truth. Halt the spread of misinformation and act of justice so that all your family may know healing. Hear our cry, O God. Heal our world, heal our bodies, strengthen our hearts and our minds, and in the midst of turmoil, give us hope and peace. Hear our cry, O God. Listen. Hold in your gentle embrace all who have died and who will die this day. Comfort the loved ones in their despair. Hear our cry, O God. Listen. Can we all join in saying the Lord's Prayer together? Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. We prepare for our communion, act of communion, with the hymn 165 in the Voice of Praise, Come Sinners to the Gospel Feast. Let us turn to page 76 of our prayer book and invite you to make the appropriate responses. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is a good and pleasant thing, joyful and salutary, always and everywhere, to give you thanks and praise. Lord God, ever living, ever blessed, almighty, all loving, through Jesus Christ, your only Son, our Lord. You created all things and made us in your image. And when we had fallen into sin, you gave him to be our Savior. He shared our human nature and lived a fully human life. He suffered rejection and condemnation and died on the cross. You raised him up from the dead, and you exalted him to the glory of your right hand, where he reigns forever as priest and king and makes intercession for us. In witness of his glory and honor, you poured out the Holy Spirit, building up many people into one body, making us living members of your holy church, and enabling us to stand before you to sing your praises and celebrate your mighty acts. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we join in the hymn of everlasting praise. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes.
Blessed are you, Lord God, King of the universe. And blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who on the night in which he was betrayed, took bread into his holy hands, looking up to heaven, gave thanks and broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this and eat it. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after the supper, he took the cup, gave thanks and gave it to them, saying, "Drink from it, all of you. This is my blood of new covenant, poured out for you and for many for forgiveness of sins. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me." Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Therefore, Father, in obedience to his command, we do this in remembrance of him, praying that you will accept our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Grant that by the power of the Holy Spirit, we who receive your gift of bread and wine, we share in the body and the blood of Christ and become united with him. And as we offer ourselves to you as a living sacrifice, we pray that you will bring us with your whole creation to your heavenly kingdom. This we pray through Jesus Christ our Lord. Holy with your Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, for all honor and glory from all who dwell on earth and in heaven throughout the ages of ages. Amen.
My brothers and sisters, the bread which we break is a sharing in the body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The cup of blessing which we embrace is a sharing the blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Please be seated as we go to God in prayer. As you are preparing your heart to die with the Lord, Just examine your life. You are talking about social justice. Are you promoting social justice or social injustice? Are you trying to help people to build in your self-esteem? Are you trying to help people to build their potential? We are reminded that the Great Commission is not only proclamation, just to hold a Bible for people to know that you are a Christian. It goes beyond that. As you draw near to this table, re-examine your life. Is the Great Commission being fulfilled in your life? That people see your life and they like to become like you. And so, Lord, we pray at this time, as we draw near to the table and dine with you, God. Those who are sick, those who are weak, those who are going through challenging times in their lives, we pray that the Lord reach out to them. Those who are sick of God, and they have been diagnosed of any kinds of illness of God, even as they eat and drink, we know there is power in the blood of Jesus. As they eat and drink, of God, bring healing to your people, of God. Touch them, of God, and release them from every pain. Whatever that is not of you in them, we pray that as they eat and drink, let everything melt away, of God, and let your people have your healing. So, Lord, bless your people as for God we come and dine with you. May your name be glorified in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Together, Lord, we come to your table, trusting in your mercy, and not in any goodness of our own. We are not worthy to gather the crumbs under your table, but it is your nature always to have mercy, and on that we repay. So feed us with the body and the blood of Jesus Christ, your Son, that we may forever live in him. And keep in us. Amen. My brothers and sisters, like I said, sit at where you are. We are coming to serve you. So sit.
This wine, now though simple, made divine. for any to receive. By your mercy we come to your table. By your grace you are making us faithful. Lord, we remember you. And remembrance leads us to worship. And as we worship you, our worship leads to communion. We respond to your invitation. See his body, his blood. Know that he has overcome every trial we will face. And none too lost to be saved.
I now invite the congregational steward to bring to us the welcome and notices.
My brothers and sisters, good morning. On this first Lord's Day in June, I greet you warmly in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And I welcome all of you wholeheartedly as we meet once again to give praise and thanks to the Most High God. To all those viewing far and wide, we are happy that you can join us, and I wish to welcome you also. However, isn't it wonderful that we can be together again in the house of the Lord? Oh yes, surely wonderful, and I'm sure you out here with me, you feel good being back here. Give me a thumbs up if you feel good. Amen. It's surely good to be in the house of the Lord. I pray that you will feel the love of Christ and be spiritually fulfilled as you partake of this worship experience. At this time, I will go through our notices for the week. As you are well aware, our March meetings, we were not able to go through with them, and so we are in the month of June, and our March meetings will take place here. So we begin with our joint congregational and pastoral council meetings. And due to the curfew, we encourage members to download Zoom so that the meeting can take place online. At Grosile, this meeting will take place on Tuesday the 16th from 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. Right here in Castries, this meeting will take place on Wednesday the 17th of June from 5 p.m. to 6:45 p.m. At Forestier, it will take place on Monday the 15th from 7:30 to 8:30, and this will be done online. Hugh Carson Brown Memorial, it will take place on Thursday the 18th of June at 7 to 8 p.m. Circuit Resources and Development Meeting. This will take place on Monday the 22nd of June right here at Castries, the time 5 to 6:30 p.m. The Joint Circuit Pastoral and Council Meeting, an appointment of circuit stewards. This meeting will take place on Monday the 29th of June 2020 at 5 p.m. to 6:30 p.m. Appointment of a circuit steward. Members of the circuit who wish to submit names for nomination of circuit stewards should send the person's name via WhatsApp or email to the superintendent minister by the 15th of June 2020. Kindly let the nominee know and seconded by another person. Sister Dr. Elfedge Brown is not eligible for nomination since she has served her 5-year term. Thank you. Good Friday, we remind you of your Good Friday and Easter Sunday appeal. We encourage all members who have not yet submitted their contributions to kindly do so. Protocol, as you know, everywhere nowadays we follow protocol, and so it is with our congregation. As you are aware, the seating arrangements have been made available for you, and I'm happy to see that you have followed through. There are others which we followed through, especially with communion. We did what we were supposed to do. We are supposed to wear masks, and I notice most of us are following through. That's very good. So I continue to remind you that there will be no handshake before or after the service, no passing of the peace during the Lord's Supper. It's mandatory that you be sanitized before entering the church. If you forget, I'm sure you would have yours in your bag with you. There'll be no such Sunday school for the time being. There are two Sunday school students at the back, but always join us every Sunday. And it's preferable that as families, we sit together. So which means parents, guardians, children, whoever you be, godparents, if you come with your little ones, allow them to sit around you as family. And the offering, as of today, you will notice it will be a walk-up offering. Thank you. At this time, I remind you of our sick and shut-in members. To name a few, we have a few of them. If you know of any others, you can pay them a visit, give them a call. On my list, I have Brother Roberto King, Brother Errol Walker, Brother Charles Miller, Brother Keith Daisy, who is at the Marian Home. Let's remember them. We also have Sister Doris Bailey, Sister Sheila Jardine, Sister Margaret Robert Steele, Sister Matilda James, Constance Barrow, and Dorothy Henry. And even for Sister Constance Barrow, let us remember her in prayer as she just lost her son-in-law. So continue to pray for her that she'll be lifted up also. On our birthday list, as you know, we have persons who share birthdays. And in the month of June, we are pleased to announce those sharing birthdays this week. We have Sister Robertina Poyot, who will be celebrating on the 8th. Sister Paulette Serrier, who will be celebrating this week, and she's sitting at the back. We have Brother Guy Ellis. We have Avron Dublin of St. Vincent, who is celebrating on the 6th. She's a young one, only 3 years old. We have Renike Harry of St. Vincent also, celebrating on the 7th, and this one will be 17 years old. So since Sister Serrier is here and we are here, we ask Sister Serrier to stand that we can sing the happy birthday to her, however we do it. Let's all join in celebrating with her this week and with all others. Happy birthday song. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Yes, we also have another gentleman, Mr. Sergis. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. May the good Lord bless you. May the good Lord bless you. May the good Lord bless and keep you. Happy birthday to you. Let me wish you all the best on this your special day, and I'm sure Reverend will show you surely pray for you, give you the blessings. Thank you. Please sit. We also celebrate with persons celebrating wedding anniversaries. And on my list, I have Mr. and Mrs. Eardley Simon. They are not with us, but I'm sure they are viewing or they are celebrating. But let us wish them well, all the best. You can give them a call, shout them up. They are not around. We wish them many blessings for their longer married life. I think I've covered it all to this end. Let me say thanks to all of you who turned up today. Thanks for our viewing audience. We are happy that you were able to allow us to come into your homes. We hope that you enjoy this worship experience. For those of us here, special thanks to Reverend for his message, timely message. Thank you to Deloro, our worship leader. Thank you to Christine, our usher at the door. Thanks to our technicians. We have Brother Chadderton, we have Abel, we have Brother Prosper, and we have Jamal, but Jamal left. Thanks everyone for being here, it was wonderful. Continue to have a wonderfully blessed day and a productive week. God bless you all.
My brothers and sisters, at this time we will have the offering. A plate is placed to the back on the table. I invite you to place your offering in the plate. Those of you who are viewing, you're reminded that your offerings can be dropped off to the church office during the course of the week. The offering on behalf of God's work.
Take my hands and let me.
Let us pray. Father, we thank you for the gift of money. All that we have, it is you that gives. So we thank you for all that you have provided for. And we have brought a token, O God, for the fragrance of your work here on earth. We pray that, Lord, you accept our gift and use it, O God, for the fragrance of your work. Even as you are accepting our gift, our lives are in your hands, O God. Continue to shower your blessings upon us. We lift our brother and our sister who are celebrating their birthdays. We pray, O God, that goodness and mercies will follow them all the days of their lives. That, Lord, they will continue to be a source of inspiration to their family and friends. That others will also be a source of inspiration to them. Whatever need they may have, we ask, O God, that you grant unto them, and let your peace that passes all understanding rest and abide with them through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen and amen. Thank you.
My brothers and sisters, we have come to the end of our worship service. Our service here has ended, but we are reminded this morning to reach out in our communities and build relationships so that the Holy Spirit can work through us. Our closing hymn is numbered 183, "To God Be the Glory," during which time the offering for the care fund will receive. The plate is placed at the back of the church. The usher will direct you as to when you can move.
My brothers and sisters, let me seize the opportunity to thank all of you. We appreciate your coming out, and also those of you who watch us from your various homes. We are so grateful to you, and we pray to God that we will continue to serve as we move forward. Let us bow our heads and receive the benediction. So, Lord, we are going to our various ways. And we know we are not departing from your presence. Your presence will go with us. That is your promise. So, Lord, we pray that, Lord, help us, O God, as we move into our communities, in our homes, we will be a voice for the voiceless to teach those people, O God, who do not know their right to have their own right to develop their full potential, that we will be able to build relationships so that your Holy Spirit will continue to work through us. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his light of countenance upon you and give you his perfect peace. The name of God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. Together, may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all now and forevermore. Amen. Thank you very much. And please don't forget, we are not supposed to shake hands, hug, or, you know, thank you.